ministry of Christ, when he came on earth, he went about doing all good. Now, he saved souls because he died for us so we can be saved. He brought repentance in cities and regions. People were transformed. We see the tax collector, Zacchaeus, when he came down from the tree and went into the mass, when the Lord went into his house, he, you know, did, you could see change in his life. So the Lord brought repentance in his presence. When he came to a city, repentance manifested. Number two, the Bible said when even was come, they brought unto him those that were sick and he healed them. The Lord healed every sick person that they brought to him. Why? Because that is what he does. For this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest, that the works of Satan might be destroyed. So this doctrine that is going around in churches, miracles don't happen, God doesn't heal today, is the will of God for you to be sick. Those are teachings that are not from Christ. Because the Lord wants to heal every sick person. Can I hear amen to that? So we have to believe him that he can heal your body and set your body free. But the first foremost thing that he wants to do is to deal with your soul. Because your soul, where is it going to go when you live this life? So salvation is the most powerful miracle that will ever happen to you. Because you could have a healed body and die and go to hell. Because you don't know Christ. But if you have Christ in your heart and you have a healed body, then you know you can do more for the Lord. Can I hear me to that? So the beginning of your healing begins from your inner man. Now, a few days ago, the Lord woke me up and he began to teach me something about his word. When we worship God, we enter into a place where we are ripe for revelation. So as you're worshiping God, the Lord releases revelation into your spirit. Amen? About Jesus. So once you receive a revelation about Jesus in your spirit, that revelation does not die. It continues to live. Let me try to simplify it for you. Jesus Christ died and rose again on the third day. He went to he rose from the dead on the third day. The Bible says so. We believe what the Bible said. Now, nobody could touch him until he went before God as a sacrifice. And then from there he came back and appeared multiple times. We see that. When he manifested, he came in glory. He never came without the glory. He came in glory because right now a new dimension had been released. When he teaches us to pray, he teaches his disciples. When you pray like this, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done here on earth as it is what? In heaven. So the Lord wants heaven's agenda, heaven's liberty, heaven's freedom, heaven's health, here on earth, as it is in heaven. Can I hear me to that? So because he wants you to be healthy and strong as it is in heaven. So, we study the scripture and we see that when we pray that prayer, we begin to connect with the heavenly rhythm, dynamic and flow. Please follow me closely here. Now, when he says, thy will be done on here as in heaven, thy kingdom come first, thy will be done here on earth as it is in heaven, then he goes on to say this very clearly. Please follow me closely. For this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest that the works of Satan may be destroyed. What are the works of Satan? Sin. The wages of sin is death, separation from God. Number two, infirmity. Four, each stripe the Lord took was to deal with infirmity. Every sickness falls under those categories of the stripes he took. So he can heal any infirmity, any sickness, any disease. Whether the doctors have a cure or not, he can heal it. Let's clap to Jesus for that.